BBC4 rather recut now. Slightly nervous about this week's Don't Watch That, Watch This.
Good evening, my fellow citizens.
I love talking about the Warren Commission. I love talking about the Kennedy assassination as well. The reason I do is because I'm fascinated by it. I'm fascinated that our government could lie to us so blatantly, so obviously, for so long, and we do absolutely nothing about it. I think that's interesting in what is ostensibly a democracy. Sarcasm. Come on in.
Bloodshed that caused so many casualties, Israelis and Palestinians, during those years, they have to make every effort to disconnect themselves.
People say, Bill, quit talking about Kennedy, man. It was a long time ago. Just let it go. All right? It's a long time ago. Just forget it. I'm like, all right, then don't bring up Jesus to me. As long as we're talking shelf life here, you know.
Strange as it may seem,
we have a shattered world.
An injustice abroad.
Two elderly sisters.
No, I don't think so.
Don't watch it.
Watch this.
Go, go, go.
I promised you blood, blood, toil, blood, toil, blood, toil. Tears and sweat and sweat. Tears and sweat. Tears. See through to the end.
Secretary of State, ladies and gentlemen, I could not be more pleased to be here today to open the royal show. I was due to be here last year performing the same function. I could not be more pleased.
One country you might want to visit here on Earth is Cuba. It has an excellent health service, perfect climate, a great nightlife, and the best cigars on the planet. Because of all this, its next-door neighbor America wants to attack it. Jealousy accounts for a great deal here on our planet.
But this is not the only answer to...
And the other thing about lawns is that they need mowing. Because strange as it may seem, cutting helps them to grow.
By the way, if anyone here is in advertising or marketing, kill yourself. Thank you. Just a little thought. I'm just trying to plant seeds. Maybe one day they'll take root. I don't know. You try. You do what you can. Seriously, though, if you are, do. No, really. There's no rationalization for what you do, and you are Satan's little helpers, okay? Kill yourself. Seriously. You're the ruiner of all things good. Seriously. No, this is not a joke. It's going to be a joke coming. There's no fucking joke coming. You are Satan's spawn, filling the world with vile and garbage. You are fucked, and you are fucking us. Kill yourself. It's the only way to save your fucking soul. Kill yourself.
بالطبع شرط بالعزاج عندما قصفوا عهد المجاورة نسية رفلون تأمهم أتعلمون حب كثيرا طريقة الأمريكان.
You know what Bill's doing now? He's going for the righteous indignation dollar. That's a big dollar. A lot of people are feeling that indignation. We've done research. Huge market. He's doing a good thing. God damn it, I'm not doing that, you scumbags. Quit putting a goddamn dollar sign on every fucking thing on this planet.
Right. I'm looking for help here, guys.
Prime Minister, can you give us an example of the sort of answer you normally give when confronted by a difficult question?
Well, you know, you can... If you want to make those comments, you can make those comments.
Oh, that's very good. Could you perhaps give us another example?
I think I'll let you determine that one. I mean, I'm sure you'd be very well qualified. Right.
Thank you. Supposing you have to blatantly lie, do you have a form of words you use for that?
I've not the faintest knowledge of any of that, I have to say.
And if the subject won't go away?
I've commented on that. I think we'll take one question at a time this time.
Excellent. Give us another.
Well, I don't think I have any response to that.
Okay, that's enough.
No, I don't think so.
Now, just before the news, time to return to Sky Sports Super Sexy Snooker Sunday.
Just rolling in, retain position on the black. Good shot.
17.
Yes, I don't know if there's a red available into any corner pocket, but there's certainly one will be available into the right centre.
One. He's been putting quite a few of those this week.
In goes the pink, but he didn't screw back far enough. Decided to play for the loose red.
A bit risky, that.
Well, I think he got into it far too much.
That's a four. Steve Davis has taken it to go one up.
Like all Americans, I'm disgusted by that kind of behavior.
In the United Kingdom, we have a profound sense of the core principles which have made our country a laughingstock in Europe. And there's now been a sea change in the way that Britain acts in the world. After more than 7 years in office, we have advanced our values and our principles on the international stage, with disastrous consequences. Throughout our history, we have sought actively to end civilization as we know it. Let me say this, I'm proud of this government's record in working for injustice at home and injustice abroad.
And you end with the grotesque chaos of a Labour government. A Labour government hiring taxes to scuttle around Brussels, handing out knighthoods to its own MEPs.
Oh yes, I'm the great pretender.
Only a Labour government can do what Guy Fawkes failed to do, blow up parliamentary government in Britain. As Labour Foreign Secretary, I know that we should, all of us, force Her Majesty the Queen to abdicate.
Ideally at point blank range.
Start with Tony Blair's comments.
America is 3,000 miles from east to west and 2,000 north to south and has a population of nearly 300 million. Cuba is 750 miles long, 50 miles wide, and has a population less than the state of Ohio. You could fit 200 Cubas inside America. That is why America is terrified of it.
Conference, the situation today in Iraq is all complete nonsense. The judgments to intervene today play into the hands of extremists and terrorists. And as for Israel, as we know, that hasn't quite happened either.
No, I mean, we know.
Don't take fame. Don't
Now that's a lesson that needs to be learned.
Gage, with your left ears. Not so many, not so many, thank God.
Most people in this country think that the Conservative Party live on another planet.
Fish.
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 Ladies and gentlemen, it is time to work even longer and harder than ever before, because we believe that society is millions of individual people worn to a frazzle. And we know that we will do precious little to help them. We Conservatives know that this country is the biggest care home in the world. It's time for a party to put an elderly person at the heart of its government.
It's not a terribly clever policy.
It's the same old song and dance that we've heard for years.
For the sake of the country and of your own happiness, I call upon you. March with me.
America's hatred of Cuba started 50 years ago when Fidel Castro came to power. At first, America liked him and helped him overthrow the previous regime, but they fell out when he wouldn't do things their way. Here on Earth, this is called True to Form.
If you're willing to condemn a group of people to a system of government that hasn't worked, and I'm ready for the job.
March with me, under the banner of freedom.
In 1962, America and Russia, the two countries that had saved the world 20 years earlier, nearly blew up the whole planet over Cuba.
Within the past week, unmistakable evidence has established the fact that a series of offensive missile sites is now in preparation on that imprisoned island.
Luckily, both sides withdrew to lick their wounds.
I'm not saying with certainty that the Russians are coming. I'm saying the trends are here. I'm not saying the Russians are 10 feet tall. I'm saying they used to be 5'3". They're now 5'9½", and they're growing.
America didn't like Russians because they smelt funny and ate beetroot. So they hatched a plan to win sympathy and thereby justify attacking Cuba.
We are the pillars of the free world.
Note by the secretaries to the Joint Chiefs of Staff, as requested by Chief of Operations Cuba Project. The Joint Chief of Staff are to indicate brief but precise description of pretexts which they consider would provide justification for U.S. military intervention in Cuba. Start riots near the base main gate, friendly Cubans. Blow up ammunition inside the base. Lob mortar shells from outside the base into base. Sabotage ship in harbor, large fire, naphthalene. Sink ship near harbor entrance. Conduct funerals for mock victims.
My experience has been that, however, most of the American people are willing to pay for that which is necessary to provide for our security.
Every man and woman, must be prepared to put his best effort into the job.
I look forward to working with the president over these coming months.
We could blow up a U.S. ship in Guantanamo Bay and blame Cuba. We could develop a communist terror campaign in the Miami area. We could sink a boatload of Cubans en route to Florida, real or simulated.
We must strive for a sane and just peace.
We could foster attempts on lives of Cuban refugees in the United States, even to the extent of wounding. Exploding a few plastic bombs in carefully chosen spots.
Hand in hand with our American allies.
When he says something, he means it. He's a big thinker. He's got a clear vision.
American.
We share the same objectives. We share the same values.
Use of MiG-type aircraft by U.S. pilots could provide additional provocation. Hijacking attempts against civil air and surface craft should appear to continue as harassing measures condoned by the government of Cuba.
These attacks were to have taken place around the US base in Cuba at Guantanamo Bay, which, ironically, is the same place those accused of being behind a real attack on America that justified military action in 2003 are now being kept. As the saying goes, what goes around comes around.
And that's what the Prime Minister means to me.
For the sake of your own happiness, I call upon you to march with me towards the beacon lights of national prosperity and honor, which must ever be our guide.
When I was just a little boy of 17, I had a girl, she was my queen. She didn't love me.
Right.